Hi everyone, welcome to this video module. In continuation to our previous module, let me introduce in this module potential appraisal purpose and characteristics and why we need to appraise performance appraisal in the organizational context, in what way it is related to human resource development. So these are the issues that we are going to understand in this video module. So if you just look at potential appraisal, it is something identify the inner talent of the individual, so that we will identify while appraising the performance. So this inner potential is required. We have to find out how is it and what is it, and it helps us to give a complete roadmap for individual career planning and career development. And the future responsibilities will be assigned or even promoted further the next level jobs based on the employees' inner potential only, right? And if you know the inner potential of our employees, that is the talent, the hidden talent that is there with our individual employees, that helps us give new challenges and then new roles, new responsibilities to our employees, right? So that is the main concept of potential appraisal. So in this module, as I was mentioning in the beginning, so we are going to understand the potential appraisal purpose, need, and then characteristics. So the learning objective of this module is, you can see that we will see what is the purpose of this potential appraisal, and then need of the appraisal, potential appraisal, and then characteristics of this performance appraisal. So we just learn all these from this video model. So first of all, let us look at the need for appraisal. So why we need to appraise the inner potential of the employee? Is it required? So if we don't appraise the inner potential, so what will happen? Because we recruit the employee, then they are working and we have given a job, and then they are showing some performance. Is it not enough? Right. So if you just look at the need of the appraisal in terms of the individual potential, so that is because it creates a competitive environment for better performance. So that inner potential identification helps us to develop a competitive environment for better performance, and it infuses a healthy organizational culture, because once we know the inner potential and then the talent, so that will develop a kind of a healthy organizational culture, and it boosting the morale and then motivation of the employees. And at the same time, you can see that it attracting and then retaining the best talent, because the organization has such a nice mechanism. Individual talent is identified, and then employees are given promotions, and then the future new roles and new responsibilities, and then that is going to develop the career of the individual in the organization. So in that way, you can see that the talented people will be attracted, and then even existing employees, they won't leave the organization. So that is the benefit, that is a need. So it is to inform the employees of their the future their prospects. Even we can inform them, these are the potential that you have, and in the line of these potentials, so you can expect that in the future you will have this kind of prospects in the organization. So this way you can inform, and then you can develop a kind of relations and then strong bondage with the employees. And at the same time, you can see that it updates the training and then recruitment activities also. So we can see the recruitment and then training and all these activities we just undertake based on all these, right? To advise and then employees about the work to be done to enhance their the career opportunities. So we can advise the employees about the work to be done in the line, and then they're supposed to enhance those, and so that we can just provide the career opportunities for them based on this potential appraisal. And then it enables the organizations to draft a management the succession planning for each and every employee. So because once they join, and after 2 years, what is going to happen? After 5 years, what will be the progress? And after the 7 years, how the employee is going to the develop within the organizations in terms of promotions, in terms of next level mobility, So everything that you know we have to tell in the succession program, right? And at the same time, we must motivate the employees to further develop their skills and then competencies, because based on the existing one, because that is not sufficient. And then based on the inner potential, so we can further develop the existing potentials to a great extent, and so that employees will take up the new roles and then jobs in future, and that will enhance the performance at the individual level. As a whole, you can see that employees going to come out with the better outcome in the organization. So if you look at the purpose of the potential the review, that is to inform employees about the future prospects, that's true, and to enable the organizations to draft management succession planning, and to update the training and recruitment activities. I think it is all we understood. And to advise the employees about their work to be done to enhance their the career opportunities. And then potential appraisal helps to identify what can happen in the future, and so that it can be the guided and then directed towards the achievement of individual and then organizational the growth and then the goals. So therefore, the potential should be included as a part of the performance appraisal in the organization, so that we can see that. So the purpose is, as well as you can see much difference between the purpose and need. So more or less the same. And then so these are the main benefits and the use of the potential appraisal. If you look at the characteristics of this potential appraisal, the process of identifying the hidden skills and then abilities of a person. So we just we adopt a system and mechanism through which it is a process to identify the hidden talent, hidden skills, and hidden knowledge of the hidden the competencies of the individual. We just trace out that, and the time for potential appraisal is not fixed. So we can find out at any time the individual potential when they are on the job and then performing their job in the organizational context. And at the same time, you can see that it's a part of performance appraisal. Of course, we just look at always, we enclose this potential, the components with the performance appraisal, so that along with the performance appraisal, so we can identify the potential also. See, it does not the guarantee the promotion. So, of course, the character is, when we have a talent, potential appraisal, inner potential, so that may not give any guarantee that we will get the the promotions or even the advancement. But it is organizations can use that whenever there is an opportunity in the organization to promote or to develop the individual employee based on the potential that is existing with them. With this, let me stop here and thank you, and let us meet in the video 116.